topic we are studying, chapter number 3, force and pressure. Okay, so already we have defined what is force. So force is a push or pull which changes the speed, direction, makes the body to move. If it is moving, makes it to come at rest. Okay, changes its shape and size. Okay, so there are various actions we are doing, or various actions make that object get changed. Okay, what changes we have observed in our day-to-day life? There are a lot of actions we are doing which is making different types of forces. Okay, so we have also seen different types of forces: muscular force, frictional force, gravitational force, electrostatic force, magnetic force. Okay, so very first we have learned what is muscular force. So muscular force is force applied by the muscles on our body. If we are picking the object, pushing, pulling, stretching, twisting, bending, what we require is force from our muscles. Okay, so such force is known as muscular force. Then we have seen frictional force. Frictional force is the opposing force exerted by the surface of two objects. Okay, like if we are moving bicycle, you know that the tires of the bicycle is made such a way that it does not get slip. Means it is what? It is having certain opposing force. So it is due to frictional force. You are not slipping. Okay. And the road is also having, the road is also made in such a way so that it, whatever object is moving through it, will not get slip. If a person is moving, if a vehicle is moving, it will not get slip from it. So, and that's why you will observe that during rainy season, we have to go very slowly, because what? There is lubricancy formed due to water. It may make the object to get slip. Okay, so frictional force is the opposing force exerted on the surface due to certain, so that is known as frictional force. Now we have also seen what is known as gravitational force. Gravitational force means simple force of attraction between any two particles. So any two particles will exert force of attraction, and that force of attraction is said to be gravitational force. Okay, so you children know gravitational force means force exerted by earth on any object. Okay, so that's why we know that if we are releasing any of the object, that it falls in downward direction. So this is due to gravitational force of the earth. Earth is attracting that particular object towards it. Likewise, moon is moving around the earth. So earth is exerting what? Force of attraction on this moon. Not only for earth or any of the satellite or any of the huge particle, you can also consider small two particles. They are also having force of attraction among them, but these masses are very less. Okay, so in the higher classes you will definitely study what actually gravitation is, gravitational forces. Okay, so that will be in detail. So in generally you should know what is gravitational force. So gravitational force is just the force of attraction between two particles, two substances. Okay, then we were studying electrostatic force. Now what is electrostatic force? Okay, so electrostatic force means electrostatic charge exerts force on each other. Now what is this electrostatic charge? Okay, what does electrostatic charge mean? So electrostatic charge word, you know, charges, there are two charges, one is positive, another one is negative charges. Now how these charges are formed? Whenever two objects are coming in contact with each other and one of the object is being charged, okay, then there will be charged from these charges, will make these charges to get attracted. Now how? Just take a simple experiment you can do at home just now. टेक प्लास्टिक रूलर रब टू योर हेयर्स. मेक श्योर दैट यू आर रबिंग ओनली इन वन डायरेक्शन. आफ्टर रबिंग जस्ट टेक अ पीस ऑफ पेपर एंड take close to it, do not stick it, just take near to it. What you will observe that automatically this paper will get attracted to it. Okay, now when that particular paper is attracting, I'll just show diagrammatically how the experiment will look. This is the ruler, okay, and this is the piece of paper. What you did, this part of the ruler you are rubbing on your hair and just it close to this paper. You will observe that the piece of paper will start to move and it will get attracted like this. First initially observe it very clearly, you will come to know that first one corner of the paper gets attracted and then the remaining paper will strike to this. So this is, these are the actions you will come to know when you see this experiment. Observe it properly, step by step. What you have observed that the ruler before striking to your hair, it is not, before rubbing to your hair, it is not attracting the piece of paper, correct? But when you rub it on your hair after rubbing, you come to know that one part of the paper first will get attracted and the whole paper gets attracted. So why does this happen? Initially before rubbing it does not attract, the scale is not attracting, but what happened after rubbing that it gets attracted, that is when you rub that particular plastic is having atoms. Okay, atoms are neutral. Neutral means no charge, either we are not saying it as positive either not negative. It is made up of, you children know, it is made up of positive charges and negative charges. Okay, these positive charge and negative charges are equal. Okay, hence they are neutral. I'll show this diagrammatically. Suppose this is atom. Okay, so this is nucleus of the atom which contain proton, neutron and electrons are revolving around it. Correct, electrons are revolving around it. Now these protons are positively charged and electrons are negatively charged. This is general idea, you children know that protons are positively charged, electrons are negatively charged. When I am talking about atom, this number of protons and number of electrons are always equal. Number of proton is equal to number of electrons. Okay, number of protons is equal to number of electrons. So hence, number of positive charge is equal to number of negative charges. If there are 5 protons in an atom, there will be 5 electrons. So 5 positive charges and 5 negative charges are balancing to each other. Hence, atom is stable, or I can say atom does not have any charge. If we are removing any electron or if we are adding electron, there will be instability in number of protons and number of electrons. Understood how? See, suppose here how many protons and electrons are there? 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 electrons. How many protons are there? Definitely number of electrons is equal to number of protons. Hence here we are having how many protons? 3 protons. Now if I am adding 2 electrons, understood? If I add 2 electrons, here there are 5 electrons and it is protons are only 3. So 5 electrons means 2 electrons are more here, or I can say 2 electrons means 2 negative charges are more here. So now this atom will not be stable, it will not be called as stable, it will not be called as atom, it will be called as ion. Okay, now this ion is having how many more charges? 2. Which? Negative. So this ion is negative ion. Okay, this is called as negative ion. So hence we can charge an atom. You understood what I want to say, why I am giving this example? To explain you that we can charge the atom. It will not be called as atom, it will be called as ion. Okay. Now what we are doing here, simply when you are rubbing this plastic ruler, it is having atom. Now due to rubbing, the outermost shell electrons, okay, the outermost electron due to rubbing, these outermost electrons come out. Okay, when these electrons are coming out, suppose one negative charge is coming out, so here just a previous example we have taken, here we are having number of electrons 3 and number of protons also 3. After rubbing this ruler, just example for example I am considering, okay. So after rubbing, how many electrons will be there? One electron is removed out. So there will be two electrons and number of proton is same, 3. So how many charges are here? Two negative charges, and how many proton is having? Positive charge, so there will be 3 positive charge. So these 2 negative and 2 positive are making it equal, but here we are having more positive. So this proton or this particular atom is having 1 positive charge. So this will be called as positive ion. Understood? So now this is positive ion. And electron is negative charge. So there will be two charges formed, positive charge, negative charge in that particular atom when it becomes unstable. And due to that, what will happen now? This positive ion and this negative charge, electron is negative charge. So one positive ion and negative charges are formed inside this part of the ruler where you are rubbing. Okay, understood. Now hence what will happen, children? Here will be negative charges formed and here we are having positive surface. Now this piece of paper is also made up of atom. You know, each and everything is made up of atom. So what will happen? Here electron clouds are formed, negative charges cloud will be formed here at the tip of the scale, correct? And here what, this particular piece of paper is neutral, okay. So continuously consider, this is plastic ruler, okay. So this area is negatively charged, correct? Negative charges are here. So you understood charges means what now? What electrostatic charge actually means? Here negative charges, negative electron, or I can say negative charge cloud will be formed, or any charge, positive or negative, any, okay. Here positive clouds or negative clouds will be formed here. Then this piece of paper is also made up of what, children's? Positive and negative equal charges. Okay, now this piece of paper whole it contains. Now due to this electron cloud, what it will do? Negative charges will from these atoms remove at one corner opposite charge. That is, suppose I'll draw it again for you children very clearly. So this is negative cloud is formed here, okay. So your piece of paper, opposite charges will be collected here due to this cloud. Cloud is heavier, it is containing one type of charges. So here automatically charges will be formed. So such charges are said to be electrostatic charge. And take this piece of paper near to it, what will happen? You will observe that. That's why when you take the ruler, first complete paper does not get attracted towards this ruler, but a side, a corner will get. And this corner contains opposite charges. And you know that opposite charges always attract to each other. Hence, negative charges will attract this positive, and after some time you will observe that the whole paper gets stick to it. Understood, children? So this is electrostatic force. So force of attraction between these two charges, opposite charges, is due to this electrostatic force. Okay, that's why without any pushing or pulling, what you observe that we are not making them in contact. They are away from each other, but still there is certain force that is pushing it. And you know, pushing or pulling is nothing but force. So this paper get pushed toward it or get pulled towards it. That pulling is nothing but force. That action makes force. Okay. So that type of force is said to be electrostatic force. Now magnetic force. You generally, you children know, you many times play with it. Magnet. Okay. Magnet means it is the material, okay, which attracts any other magnet or magnetic material. Magnetic material means iron. If you take iron nail, what will happen? It will stick to magnet. So that force due to magnet acting on other magnetic material, okay, so force due to magnet or magnet or force due to magnet on other magnet, another magnet, or on another magnetic material is known as magnetic force. Like if we take, suppose these are two magnets, if we'll take come if we'll make to come here towards each other, what will happen? Either they will attract, either they will repel. You know the condition when they attract, when they are having opposite poles. Opposite poles means, you children know that